Boyds. Hardwood Gunstocks.
Hi, Randy Boyd here. When's your gun accurate enough? Well, if you're like me, the answer's never. You can gain just a little more accuracy on your gun if you glass bed it, and it's not that hard. Let me show you.
I free float all my barrel channels, and I want them to stay that way. So by glass bedding the receiver, this improves the foundation and eliminates any movement.
We're going to glass bed this using Acker glass. That's been around forever, and it's a great bedding compound. As you notice in the receiver area, I'm not going to have to remove any wood because I have ample area to fill with Acker glass. Generally, when I glass bed, I only glass bed the front lug to about a half inch up the barrel channel. But in this case, I have a really heavy barrel, and so I'm going to put some on the sides of the back tang to stop any of that side-to-side movement as well. I like using an aerosol for a release agent because it ensures it's getting the oil up into all the screw holes, and I really cover the action good so that I don't stick the two together. Right at this point, I've just put a little oil on the rag and just wiping all the excess off the outside of the stock. The reason I use the oil is so that it doesn't smear. Okay. Release agent is really, really important. If you don't have everything coated with some kind of a lubricant, a non-evaporating lubricant, odds are you're going to stick the barrel action in the wood. Okay, I'm just giving the stock a complete wipe down with an oily rag to make sure that I don't have Acker glass stuck somewhere on the outside of the stock. Now I'm just going to leave it set and cure for 24 hours. Okay, it's been 24 hours. Now I'm just taking the action out of the stock. You notice how easy the floor plate comes out? Now I'm just going to tap it out towards the end of the barrel and take my action out. Again, that's why it's so important to use a good release agent. I'm not a huge fan of WD-40 because that seems to evaporate, but prior to putting this in, you notice how I had everything just saturated with the oil. I had it up in the screw holes. I had it everywhere. And that's just to ensure that the Acker glass isn't going to stick the barrel into the stock. I've completed the final cleanup. I've ensured that the overrun of the bedding compound, there's no interference between that and any working mechanisms of the barreled action. I've gone through the barreled action, the trigger, the floor plate, and ensured that there's no bedding compound got in any of these areas. And now it's time to free float the barrel channel. If you want to know how to do this, watch our free float video. It's important to note that when I took the Boyd stock directly out of the box and bolted this barreled action into it, I was shooting under a 1-inch group at 100 yards. But I want to improve upon this. And by glass bedding a stock, it all but eliminates any movement opportunity in the receiver area, and it will improve on your accuracy. I'm Randy Boyd, and thanks for watching.